Oh, hello there. Are you a chip fan? Here, let me let you in on a little industry secret. The chip flavor actually comes from DNA. How does that so? Let me tell you. So here we are given a DNA sequence that needs to be transcribed into an amino acid protein sequence that is 4 amino acids long. So that those 4 amino acids are going to consist of a start codon, 3 amino acids, and then a stop codon. The start codon is what we should look for first, and that's going to be ATG on a DNA, but then it's going to be AUG in an RNA because thymine gets converted to uracil during transcription. So since transcription happens in the 5' to 3' direction, we're going to start at the top strand up here, and right away we have a AUG start codon, so then we're going to start counting. We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then we have a UGA, which is a stop codon, but since this is 5 amino acids long, not really what we're looking for. So we're going to start down here at the 5' and head in the 3' direction. So we got AUG right here at the start codon, so we're going to do 1, 2, 3, 4, and then we get to the fifth one, which is a stop codon, UAA. So 4 amino acids, that's what we're looking for. So since our desired sequence is on the bottom strand, we can conclude that it is the coding strand and that the top strand is the template strand. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to flip the coding strand so it goes from 5' to 3', and then we can go on to the transcribing and translating of the DNA. After transcribing and translating our DNA sequence, we get our mRNA sequence, which is MVSK stop, which codes for Miss Vicky's jalapeno kettle chips. So how do we get different types of chips? Well, single point nucleic acid mutations happen on the DNA strand, and this causes the mRNA strand to change up a little bit, changing the type of chip. For example, if we wanted to have Fritos Flavor Twist Honey Barbecue chips, the guanine in the DNA would have to go through transversion and turn into a cytosine. That would then change this amino acid from an S to a T, changing the entire protein, which would give us this flavor. And this mutation is called missense, because an amino acid is changed. Now, if we wanted Doritos spicy sweet chili chips, the adenine in DNA right here would have to go through transversion to turn into a thymine. This thymine through transcription would turn into a uracil, which would change this codon into a stop codon, shortening the amino acid sequence. And this type of mutation is called a nonsense mutation, since a codon was turned into a stop codon. Hypothetically, let's say this cytosine in the DNA goes through a transition mutation into a thymine, which then gets transcribed into a uracil. This GUU amino acid codes for a V, which is the same as our original mRNA. So you would call this mutation a silent mutation, which would result in the Miss Vicky's jalapeno chips. If you wanted to end up with Funyuns, you would need to go through a read-through mutation, and we can accomplish that by having the adenine go through a transversion mutation into a cytosine, which would then change this into a UAC, which is not a stop codon, causing the transcription to continue happening. References.